My name's Rob Shoplock. I'm the Vice President of the Professional Firefighters of Idaho, and I am a Battalion Chief with the Eagle Fire Department. In the last 12 years, I've spent lobbying for the Professional Firefighters of Idaho, and have had the opportunity to work with a lot of first responders around the state. Over the last 5 years, we started really noticing a trend where our first responders were opening up a little bit more to one another. As we started having conferences, learning about how to help one another, and it really started for us, at least in the fire service, where we started a program called Saving Our Own. You know, we've got a lot of issues at the firehouses. We need to start taking that Saving Our Own and bringing that back and to the mental awareness of one another. How do people deal with the issues they see? And then there was quite a few people that started calling, emailing me, saying, you know, I've been having trouble sleeping, I've been turning to alcohol quite a bit, I'm on antidepressants. A lot of our mental stress and injuries started manifesting more into these physical ways. That led to, okay, let's collaborate with first responders and find out how we can take care of our members. What we found was, in Idaho, unless you had a physical manifestation from an injury, you could not make a workers' comp claim. If law enforcement went into a school shooting, saw multiple deaths of children or a very traumatic event like that, and they all of a sudden started having maybe a mental breakdown, were not able to come to work, a change in habit, that wasn't something that was covered under work comp. And we really felt like, as firefighters, as first responders, it's our job to take care of one another. And then the community started rallying around the support of, let's take care of our first responders. The rates of suicide in the last decade have gone through the roof on first responders. That's where we started drafting legislation, and you know, to this point, it's making sure the information is out there and that all our first responders know that it's there, how to access it, and what it actually means. When this legislation did pass, we had very few legislators vote against it. One of the biggest reasons we got the big support we did is we put a sunset clause on it. And as I mentioned before, it is very important for us to make sure that our organizations stay profitable. And when I mean profitable, I mean that we are not bankrupting the system with taking people offline and causing more overtime, that we're not taking people off work, hoping they get better at home. But through the work comp system, there is progress reports, there is accountability. And this is the time where your Idaho first responders, we're coming to you in the public, and we're going to be asking for your support. That means logging on to the link, being part of the email list, following social media, and hearing the calls when we do go back to session and we go to remove the sunset, because we do need to keep this healthy workforce going. This trend that we've started 2 years ago, where mental health is being addressed, injuries are being healed. We have members that are going and they're getting inpatient counseling. We have first responders that are seeing counselors. We have marriages that are being saved. We are building a stronger workforce mentally, which then obviously leads to the better customer service in the long run. When the message comes out, the call to action comes, we would ask you to please contact your legislator and ask them to repeal the sunset off of this bill. It would make a huge impact on the state, and we certainly appreciate your support.